Mega World announces a 1.2 billion peso museum project in its Mactan property in Cebu. The property developer's museum will rise near its Newtown residential condominium. Mega World says it will feature pieces and artifacts to highlight relations between the Philippines and Spain. The Mactan Museum is eyed to open in the next 3 years. Now, this would become Mega World's fourth museum after one in Chinatown, Binondo, and two in Iloilo Province. And PhilInvest's Real Estate Investment Trust says five of its office building properties are now powered by renewable energy. The properties that switch to RE are PhilRT's buildings in Northgate in Alabang. The Gutianon-led firm says the move reflects its commitment to environmental responsibility. The Philippine Justice Department warning police officials against cooperating with the International Criminal Court's probe into the Duterte administration's bloody drug war. DOJ Assistant Secretary Mico Clavanos asserts they can hold any official accountable for going against government's policy of not cooperating with the ICC investigation. Former Senator Antonio Trillanes claimed the ICC has already contacted dozens of current and former police officials implicated in the crime against humanity case against former President Rodrigo Duterte.
We have not received the same information. No? So just like everybody else, we found out from Senator Trillanes about this supposed development. But I think we've been consistent from the very start that we have a working justice system here in the Philippines. As mentioned by the Solicitor General, this is a government policy. So when a government officer or official is coordinating with the ICC against the direction or the orders and the policy of the government, there may be accountability involved. So it's, you know, if there's any law enforcement or government official that goes against the policies and orders of the authorities in position, then obviously there will be some sort of conflict of interest. There will be accountabilities.
Duterte's anti-narcotics campaign officially claimed over 6,000 lives, but some have placed that estimate at around 30,000. The power grids of Luzon and Visayas placed on alert again still due to the hot weather. The Philippine grid operator NGCP says the Luzon grid was placed on yellow alert at 1 p.m. and will remain so until 5. The yellow alert will be issued again from 7 p.m. to 11. 12 plants in Luzon have been down this month. As for the Visayas grid, its yellow alert status is as follows: 1 to 4 p.m., 6 to 7 p.m., and again from 8 to 9 p.m.